Menteri rang ba kejelah ukan rat ki sangma ringkat ki menteri ke sarkar Meghalaya Democratic Alliance menta kesingi kelak tu yulat kejelah utata kata roy ban ai mohono ya ka ordinance jangka Meghalaya Resident Safety and Security Act bad ban penjerino ya kesensar administrator ha kasels autonomous district council haba kren megila thai kbor hadin ke jing kenduk bolat kejelah ukan rat ulong bola pensyai bon ke ke ki ba ulat umna sengtho ke ba pelong yu wan pen slam hakaban soi ya ka ordinance bad benrap ba menta ke sarkar kan nang up kumno ulat unle hadi ma ke sarkar kla de ban pensyai kat kum ke jing ong jong menteri rang ba ulat ula pan jing syairu ya kumno kata ka rukam rung ki breu kan trekam bad ki ba kumno ki breu ken hap hakik kendon jong kan ikaan la ki breu ki ba shuan kai bhayeng ki hap hakani ke juk ka kendon ban hap pen rung kerteng ukanat ula benrap ru ba barok kini kimat ansara ru haka MRSSA Menteri Rangba ulai itu susu bolat ke jelah ulai keli. Laki ain ke serka pening kem ke labor bat ke migrant acts. Kebelah dan lupa kincak pendam no haka MRSSA. Hendai nak kelihang kanrat ulai pensyai baki ain ke serka pening kebelah dan kenang nge bat rekam. Menteri Rangba ulai itu rubah hadian kejing pensyai na ke serkar. Ulat ulai penpau ya kejing sanghun namar baka MRSSA. Kelong nak bentang menyuak jingtip ya kibriu kibawan rung syah kini ke jelah. Haba kelipat na ulat ke jelau tata kata roy bahadu kat no kan simpor yu halor kene kekam ulat ulong ba kene kam dei kekam ke barit hendai kene kekam ke bahap bane fliu jumbat bha badun persyang ban perkloi ke bala
mainly we had two issues we discussed with the honorable governor. One was the related to the Meghalaya Residency and Safety Act, the ordinance, and we briefed the governor on all the details of this act amendment. And we urged the governor that if this could be, approval could be given for that ordinance at the earliest. And the second issue that we discussed with him was regarding the Khasiyal's Autonomous District Council and the fact that the instability even exists even now. And within a matter of 10 days, the majority has been shifting from one side to another side, and then back to the other side, and again back to the other side. I think this is not a very healthy practice, and it's leading to a lot of horse trading, leading to a lot of unhealthy environment within the council. And this needs to be dealt with in a manner which will ensure that in the long term there is at least some sense of stability in the system. And keeping that in mind, we have urged the governor to put in the administrator rule and take over the administration of the council and give it to the deputy commissioner. These were two issues, and in both the issues the governor has very patiently listened to all the points that we mentioned, and then definitely he has told us that he will go through all the facts and he will accordingly exercise his mind and exercise his power. Yeah, he had a lot of clarifications, and we were happy to clarify. And I think the clarifications have really cleared some of the doubts that the Honorable Governor had. And so let us see and how the Governor will react to it. No, there were issues regarding points like how will entries take place, who are the people who come within the ambit of this rules, will relatives coming in for meeting people, will they be under this rule, and we have to register. So we said, sir, those are areas that will be defined in the rules itself, and those are areas where we will do a lot of consultation to ensure that it comes out in a proper manner. So those were some of the concerns that were clarifications that were asked. It was also asked clarification whether the national and the central rules that are there regarding the labor and migrant acts that are there, will they be overruled by this? So obviously we clarified that it will not. Those acts will remain, those acts will be applicable, and this is only an addition, and it will be a system where the information will be sought by individuals coming in. And all these factors were informed to him, and then he was convinced about those points that were mentioned by us. I think the NPP has been very clear from day one that the people of the state, the protection must be given to the people of the state. The CAB, which was there earlier, provisions must be included in that to protect our state and to protect our people. Based on that, the old bill that was there, we had moved with the government, and we had said that we are not accepting that particular bill in that format. Consequently, objections were raised last time when the session took place. We had also opposed the stand that time, and we had ensured that the bill did not go through. Post that, as you've seen, many consultations took place. One of our concerns was regarding, you know, people coming in from Bangladesh on a continuous basis. And therefore, this was a very big concern that our Honorable MP had also raised, and government also had raised, and we also as a party had raised. This particular issue has been addressed to a very, very large extent by ensuring that there's a cutoff date. So therefore, as mentioned yesterday also in my thing, that this will be meant and will be looked at for people who have been staying here for a long time. So here means in India. So in Assam, for example, there have been many people from Bangladesh who were Hindus who came in and stayed here, and you know, and have been there for a certain number of years. So this has been the issue at that point. And so when the government put in the date of 2014, we have gone through our data and information. And as I said, as of now, the information with me is that in the whole state of Meghalaya, there is only one person who has actually applied under this particular act. Only one person. And there's no question of any other person applying anymore. So I think, so these issues of putting in the cutoff date was something that has really ensured that a big concern of a lot of people. I heard one MLA was speaking and saying that, you know, well, now 1 crore 70 lakh Hindus are going to come into, from Bangladesh are going to come into our country. I think that's a misconception. We also felt that we need some provisions where maybe Meghalaya state can be exempted totally, so that there is no, you know, there is no issue and there's no apprehension among the people, no fear among the people that whether it will not, what if. So that's when government of India said, okay, for Meghalaya, we will put the provisions of the Sixth Schedule. For other states, we will put other provisions. This was not there before. And it is only after our Member of Parliament and the political parties and other groups met the Honorable Home Minister, these provisions were inserted. So I think after we saw all these kind of provisions coming in, all these kind of protections coming in, there was a large sense that yes, government has handled this situation in a different manner this time. Many provisions have been put in, but we would want that Meghalaya as a whole, if it can be exempted, that is what we've been demanding now. And so even today, our Honorable MP has met the Home Minister, and the Home Minister gave a very positive response, and that he will be examining this matter. And she has proposed that the whole of Meghalaya should be exempted, and hopefully we will get a positive response. Tomorrow, I am leading a team of my cabinet colleagues to the to meet the Home Minister in Government of India, and we are going to be meeting him tomorrow evening, and we'll continue to press on this issue. And that is the kind of work that's happening. And so therefore, all these measures have been taken. But our demand and our request to the government of India, once again, is to find provisions to keep strengthening, you know, so that the provisions, so that more insulation can be given to the people of the state. We have been discussing with different organizations also. And the government also has been debating on this internally. And since the Meghalaya Resident Safety Act is something that is a provision that is made by the state of Meghalaya, something that is very much within our control. It was decided earlier also that if the Residency Act comes in, it is a mechanism which will serve the same purpose as an ILP. So therefore, we are stressing on this, and we, as I said, that's the reason why we met the governor, and we are waiting, and we're hopeful that the governor will take a positive decision on this matter. In the current situation, as I said, the majority shifted from the UDA to the UPF. Within 1 week, it again shifted from the UPF to the UDA. Then again, there's a shift from the UDA to the UPF. So here we are seeing, as I said, a flip-flop situation, which is really not giving a good image to the KHDC. And therefore, keeping this kind of a fluid situation in mind, which is not healthy for the overall functioning and governance of the KHDC, we felt that this point in time, the governor should take the administration so that the things can settle down and a clear picture may emerge after maybe some time, maybe weeks or months. And at that point, we may be in a better position to take a decision on how to move forward. But in the current situation, seeing the flip-flop, seeing the fluid situation, seeing the the imbalance and the kind of instability that's there, we have recommended that governor should take over, because in a matter of 10 days, the majority has been shifting from one group to the other, which really does not look nice for the council as well.
We have had a very meaningful discussion with Chief Minister, the Deputy Chief Minister and his cabinet members. It lasted for nearly 2 hours, and during this we had threadbare discussion about the two subjects. They must have already briefed you. That is all that I have to say. Further action I shall take upon mature consideration.
Sir, for how long it will take?
That I cannot say, because these are not very petty matters. These are very important matters which will require great deliberation. The Chief Minister made a plea that time is of the essence. He used these words, time is of the essence. So I will have due regard to his words, and I'll try to do it as early as possible.